Good morning, church, and welcome to Sunday, October 17th. Esther Knopfsinger will start us off with, I Know Whom I Have Believed. Sunday's devotion is found in the Upper Room Discipline, written by Diana Hinson. And the scripture reading this morning is Hebrews 5, 1 through 10. Every high priest chosen from among mortals is put in charge of things pertaining to God on their behalf, to offer gifts or sacrifices for sin. He's able to deal directly with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is subject to weakness. And because of this, he must offer sacrifice for his own sins as well as those of the people. And one does not presume to take this honor, but takes it only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son, today I have begotten you," as he also says in another place, "You are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey him. Having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. In the scriptures for this past week, God spoke through the prophet Joel, the psalmist, the whirlwind, and Jesus, God incarnate. Today we have the witness of this cosmic yet earthly God and how God's power works on behalf of mankind and humankind. Hebrews tells us that Jesus was assigned the role of high priest, not to glorify himself, but because God designated him. He offered up prayers and supplications for himself while in the flesh, and he learned obedience through suffering and was perfected in thus is the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The identity of high priest is not something that Jesus claimed of himself in the Gospels, though the high priest is responsible for the holiness and well-being of the community. The Gospels do not suggest that Jesus had to be perfected through suffering, but they do portray his human anguish and his petition to be delivered from that suffering and to show his perfect obedience in enduring it. Consider the characteristics of the mortal high priest: to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins and to deal gently with the ignorant and the wayward. The high priest does not presume but acts because of God's call. Each of us, by God's power and by the example of Jesus Christ, is capable of and called to such a role. What might you do better or differently if you viewed yourself as a humble agent of God, to deal gently with the ignorant or the wayward? What would change if you were to offer gifts and sacrifices for sin, if only for your own? How might you act differently if you kept at the front of your mind that you are subject to weakness and that you may also be the ignorant or wayward person? What might be the response of others if you consistently demonstrated this kind of servanthood? Let us pray. O gracious God, guide us to seek the Christian perfection that is possible through perfect submission to your will. Amen. Our closing hymn is Blessed Assurance. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Blessings to you all week.